My name is Blanche. I'm from the Netherlands and I live in Zanzibar since 2.5 years. The people who run this place, they like animals. So the animals here, the cats here, are very lucky, the stray animals. And there's a cat family living here. I worked here and I saw the many stray cats here in this particular area. And one family living here was a male cat, a female cat, and 3 kittens. They had a litter together. I thought, okay, the people who run the place are okay with it, as long as they don't bother too many people. So I take them to the cat clinic to get spayed. They live together with their litter like a family in peace, and that's it. But kittens started disappearing. Before I was able to take all 3 of them to the veterinary clinic, the mama I took, the papa I took, but kittens disappeared. Okay, but maybe they went exploring and the ocean waves were high and they got sucked in by the waves because they don't know how to deal with them. I don't know. That's the first thing I thought. Then another one disappeared and I thought, is staff killing kittens here? Maybe a horrible thought, but not everyone likes cats. And people who live here as staff members might be annoyed by screaming kittens. I don't know. They all said, no, we don't do this. No. So, okay, what can you do? Look for them, call for them, ask everyone. No, they're gone. Okay. Then I noticed outside, there's a big colony of cats living outside. Also, there were 3 little ones. They started disappearing too. And one of them, because you just don't see them anymore from one day to another. One of them I saw before the day before he disappeared, he did not eat. And he just sat there being quiet. And I thought, okay, maybe he ate something wrong, it's possible. But in the end, there's about 14 cats, mostly small ones, but also bigger ones started to disappear in the last year and a half. Since last year, April. Then, last week, the cat family who was living here, had a new litter, the mama, before she got spayed, now she cannot. One of them disappeared. Then, she had 2 kittens left. One of them also did not want to eat. And she cried a high-pinched cry and sat here, actually. And I thought that's odd because she always eats out there. But again, I thought, I hope she ate something wrong. Because you don't know. You don't know if they eat maybe some bad fish somewhere and just for one day they throw up and you don't know. But it was odd because it was the same as the other little one. Not moving, sitting still. But this one was crying, a very sincere cry, very sad. And that was, so the next morning I got a short video from the people working here of the little kitten laying with not foam but I don't know, slime coming out of her mouth, and she gave her last cry. I did not know it was they phoned me if I could come and take her to the cat clinic. Yeah, of course. And while I was getting dressed, she just died, so I was too late. Then, later, when I arrived, there was blood out of her nose, blood out of her behind. I contacted the vet, and they said, yeah, she's poisoned, because this has every sign with not eating anymore, sitting quiet, crying like she's in pain. You saw it on the film, the boy sent me, blood coming out of everywhere. So all these cats are being poisoned by, I think, people who live here next door. And for what reason, I don't know. They left me a note on the tree, I think about 6 weeks ago, telling me I should not feed cats because in Cabo Verde is a big cat problem. And there's too many cats on Cabo Verde and they bring disease. So I left them a note back on the tree, asking them to contact me to discuss this, because the only zoonosis cats that bring diseases to people I'm aware of is the cat scratch disease and disease which you can get if you touch their poop, which is only dangerous for small children and pregnant babies.